Hello, good morning everybody. In this video, we'll show error messages when a client tries to connect to an invalid room or the game of the room already started. In the join dialog script, create a new function called showError, with the parameter that will contain the text of the error. Inside the function, put the error message in the label and show it. Open the client script and create a function with the same name and the same parameter. Add remote since we are going to call this function from the server. Call the showError function of the join dialog, passing the message as argument. Now, open the server project and create two constants with the error messages. One in case of connecting to a room that does not exist, and the other for connecting to a room where the game started. Go to the join room function. Let's add some conditions. If there is no room with the ID specified by the client, call the show error function, passing the corresponding error message. Disconnect the player with the disconnect peer function. If the state of the room is started, it means the game already started. Call the showError function and pass the error message. Like before, disconnect the player. If none of these two conditions are true, execute the addPlayerToRoom function to add the player to the room. Let's try it. If I try to join a room, I get an error. The problem is that by mistake, I put the showError function in the menu script instead of the client script. The server cannot find the function if it's not in the client script. After moving the function, it works. But we have a problem. The join dialog is closed and we can see the message. We have to find a way of not hiding it. We can do it adding a variable in the menu script. In the showError function of the client script, change the keepJoinDialogOpen variable of the menu script to true. But we have not declared this variable yet. So go to the menu script and declare it. Initialize it to false since we want to close the dialog by default. The function that closes the joinDialog is the removeAllPlayers function. Scroll down until you find it and add an if before hiding the join dialog. If keep join dialog open is true, change the value of the variable to false, so the next time the pop-up will be closed. Let's try it. It does not work. The join dialog keeps closing. That's because I messed up the if we added. Add an else, so the join dialog is hided only if keep join dialog open is false. So if keep join dialog open is true, the join dialog will not be closed, because we are not calling his hide function. If keep join dialog open is false, we call his hide function like before. It works now. When the player tries to join a room that does not exist, a message appears. Let's make some improvements to the message. Since it's an error message, change his color to red using the moderate property of the label. To avoid the text overflow, let's add another font, one that is smaller. The error message looks better now. Let's try to reproduce the other error, the one that shows up when a player wants to join a game that already started. I open it to clients. If I start a game in the room 0 with the first client and I try to join this room with the second client, the error message will appear. That's all. I hope you liked the series and learned it as much as I did. Thanks for watching and see you in the next video.